In this video, I will provide an introduction to the semivariogram. A semivariogram is a graphical representation of the concept of spatial autocorrelation. On a semivariogram, the x-axis represents distance between sample points, or lag. In the graph space, each point represents a pair of samples or observations. The x-coordinate is the lag, or distance between the samples. The y-axis is the semivariance, which is a measure of the spatial dependency between two samples or observations. High semivariance suggests that the two observations or samples have very different values, whereas low values of semivariance suggest that they have very similar values. Based on Tobler's first law of geography, we would expect nearer objects to have more similar values and further objects to have less similar values, or nearer objects are expected to have low semivariance, whereas samples that are more separated are expected to have higher semivariance. This is the concept of spatial autocorrelation. The semivariogram shown here represents simulated data. Please pardon the quality of the drawing. Real data are likely to show a more complex or noisy pattern. Let's investigate a few key features of the semivariogram. First, the distance at which the semivariance stops increasing is the range. This value can be determined by extrapolating from the fitted semivariance curve to the x-axis. Samples that are closer together than this distance are spatially autocorrelated. Samples that are further than this distance are not spatially autocorrelated. The SIL is the semivariance at the range, or the semivariance at the distance where spatial autocorrelation is no longer present. You would expect the semivariance at a distance or lag of zero to be zero, or you would expect samples at the same location to have the same value. However, this is not always the case for real data. This is known as the nugget effect. This arises due to measurement error of spatial sources of variation at distances smaller than the sampling unit. The partial SIL is the semivariance obtained when the nugget is subtracted from the SIL. Again, the semivariogram can be thought of as a graphic representation of spatial autocorrelation. In this example, near features tend to have a lower semivariance or are more correlated, whereas more distant features tend to have a greater semivariance or are less correlated. At a certain distance, the range, samples are no longer spatially autocorrelated and the semivariance stops increasing. So near features have more similar values than observations that are more separated, or spatial autocorrelation is present. Again, real data are likely to show a less obvious or more noisy trend than this hypothetical example.